What's up, nerds? It's your boy, the OG GM, coming to you live at 8 o'clock in the morning here on another foggy, rainy day on Site B, the first day of spring. So hopefully spring is listening, that it's the first day of spring, and will actually show up. And speaking of spring, segue, it's time to spring... See what I did there? Spring some bundles! Bundles, that's right. It's Monday. It's time to take a look at all the tabletop role-playing game bundles. Freebies, collections, stuff like that. Remember, of course, as always, unless I specifically say otherwise, these are PDFs. These are not physical products. Because they're PDFs and because we're involving the digital marketplace, before you download and install any of these, please check them for malware and viruses. You could be saying to yourself, oh no, that doesn't happen, there's just PDFs, but I assure you it has happened to me twice, and I've been contacted by at least four other people so far saying it has happened to them. So if you purchase any of these PDFs and download them before you open them, check them for malware and viruses. Now, because we are talking about charities with the bundles again, and I know I'm gonna get in trouble for this someday, I'm surprised I haven't, when dealing with the charities, maybe if there's a charity I mention that you want to support, just give the money directly to the charity instead of doing the bundle. Because, you know, I mean, while there is a really amazing Trollord Games bundle, I'm never gonna get that right, Castles and Crusades Trollords game bundle and a Shadowrun bundle, maybe it's a charity you want to support, but you don't really want the bundle. And you never, you know, I mean, it's just finally at the end of the day, if it's a charity you want to support, just give the money directly to the charity, I would say. Sorry, bundle people, but yeah. Okay, let's take a look first at the freebies. And as always, these are going to be on DriveThruRPG or the GM's Guild. And by this picture, I have a feeling that our theme this week is Star Trek. Ish. Okay, Noah Katzen has released Neon Scissors Run, a game about trying to figure out what's going on in the game. Yeah, that sounds dumb. Kyler G has released a role-playing game called Resistance is Futile, a science fiction alien invasion role-playing game, where multiple alien races compete with humanity for control of Earth. That sounds more like a board game, but okay. Also, Resistance is Futile. Isn't that what the Borg say? I mean, I don't think you can copyright a saying, but that's pretty close to Borgish. And the Star Trek people might go, hey, wait a second. There is a Mork Borg bestiary available from Matthew Feister called Freak Show. It's got... a whole bunch of monsters designed for Mork Borg, and he updates it every month, and this is free. Cool. So it's an ongoing project. Thank you. Of course, you could just head on over to BIG GEEK EMPORIUM and pick up my beasteries. I've got a 9th one that I'm just about to post, and we're working on the 10th. So, you know, if you want to support somebody who's making beasteries every month, maybe head on over to BIG GEEK EMPORIUM and pick up mine. We've got some new Prestige classes. This one comes from us from a person named Huey Einfield. It's called Prestige. And it's a collection of Prestige classes for 5e. Because, you know, the classes in 5e aren't broken enough. It's the guy wants to go, hey, I'm going to give you a Prestige class that does stuff. I mean, even though multiclassing is relatively simple in 5e now, and the 5e classes on their own are just pretty intense, this guy wants to up the power rating even more with 5e Prestige classes. The Gorilla of Destiny brings us some new spells and a workbook on how to create new spells. It's called the Spell Writing Guide, and this is by a gentleman who calls himself Gorilla of Destiny. Are you aware there is a tag team called the Gorillas of Destiny? And they might not like the fact that you're using their name. Anyways, over at DM's Guild, we have our usual collection of stuff. We've got a optional rules for lockpicking in 5e, because, you know, lockpicking in 5e isn't in-depth or complicated enough. So this guy has added new complications to the relatively simple roll a d20 mechanics of lockpicking, because apparently that's something he thinks people want. I always like the idea of just giving them a real puzzle, and if they solve it, they pick the lock. But then that sort of ruins the whole point of having a guy who's like, I've got plus 12 with lockpicking, but in real life, I can't solve this puzzle. That's not fair. We have got some more subclasses. Cypher CA has presented us with something called subclass roulette, which allows you to mix and match features from different subclasses. So basically adding the gestalt rules to 5e, but that, as that seems the direction that 5e is going anyways, into 6e, if we can get any hints from the stat blocks for the characters from the D&D movie. Yeah. So I guess he's trying to beat it to the punch. So if you want to have the ability to mix and match from different prestige classes and subclasses in 5e, now you could. Michael LaBoisa has presented us with 30 new maps up on DM's Guild. We've also got some Spelljammer maps as well as fantasy maps. So if you're looking for some free PDF maps that you want to download, just head on over to DM's Guild and just do a search for maps, or do a search under Michael's name. There's a Spelljammer adventure. Robbie Pleasant has brought us a Spelljammer adventure called The Ghost Ship, a tier one convention mission, which a 2-hour time slot. So this guy's run this at conventions, and now he's making it to the general public. And it's got a time slot. That's interesting to see how that would work. We've got an adventure for 5th level characters called Nothing Out of the Ordinary from Julian Cross. It appears to be just a classic tale of good versus evil, fighting over a village, but there's a twist. I always like a good adventure with a twist. Bess Klein has brought us a card game, which that has nothing to do with role-playing. It's a card game. Dude. It's not a board game. Card game news. It's role-playing game bundle news. So why are you, get out of here. And then, of course, we have the usual lightning round of new classes and maps available on DM's Guild like we do every week. Every week, there are a huge collection of free maps and free new subclasses and builds that are available from multiple individuals that just DM's Guild put together as packages and just bush them all together. So this week we have only three new maps this week, but we have 9 new specialty subclasses, whatever you want to call them, builds available to you if you are looking for new and exciting ways to stretch out your 5e game and perhaps get some ideas for new subclasses, because the 48 that currently exist might not be enough for you. Here you go. But as always with these, before you implement them into your game, make sure it's okay with your DM and all your players, because, you know, these haven't gone through the Wizards of the Coast fine-tuning and very astute press. These are third-party stuff available on DM's Guild, so they might be overpowered, they might not work with your game. So before you invoke the Path of the Platypus, because that's one of them, and now I want to play a character with the Path of the Platypus so badly, make sure it's okay. All right, now we have bundles and sales. We have a collection from Kobold Press. It's all their Kobold Guides, which is a series on adding to 5e builds. They've got like a one called Game Design, World Building, stuff like that. So basically it's just a bunch of things that they've been doing over the years to give you ideas on how to design, build, implement games. And they have kindly bundled them all together in a huge bundle for $108 to include a whole bunch of stuff about game design, world building, stuff like that. So if that's something you feel you need and you got $108 laying around, pick this up. Remember, these are all PDFs, no physical copies. And maybe Kobold will take some of that money from your purchasing of it and use it to, I don't know, further their work on Project Black Flag. There is a, moving on, there's a sale on Fantasy Grounds. Fantasy Grounds being one of the many VTTs that are competing with the Dungeons & Dragons VTT that we still haven't actually seen yet and are trying to remain solvent and ahead of the curve before Hasbro attempts to gain control of the digital universe. So they have added up a whole bunch of new stuff, including rule books, additional VTT games you can play, like Cyberpunk and stuff like that. So for $25, you can get all the new upgrades, site licenses, tile sets, and everything that has been changed and upgraded. It's 25% off on all that stuff. So you go on to Fantasy Grounds, you pick up the, you know, you look for the one you want, like, oh, I want to play Cyberpunk Red, and I want to run it on a VTT. And normally Cyberpunk Red and all the things for it would cost me, I don't know, $10. Probably more, but that's the first number that I popped in my head. Well, now you can get that for 25% off. And then it just downloads everything, and then you check it for viruses and malware, and then you put it up onto Fantasy Grounds, and everybody says, oh, yay, we're going to play Cyberpunk Red. Thank you for spending money to get us all the stuff that we can play it. So I think that's how it works. Mind you, to me, virtual tabletops and pretty much anything dealing with computers is magic, so I could be wrong. And speaking of VTDs, Roll20 is also running a sale. This time on these, they're doing Paizo stuff. They've got a Pathfinder, core rulebook, advanced rulebook, some of the supplemental stuff, and the Adventure Path. It's all for second edition, Kingmaker Adventure Path specifically, but a couple others. Kingmaker, I think, one of the best APs they ever made for Paizo Pathfinder first edition. I'll be interested to see how they changed it for second. So it's 40% off, so head on over to Roll20. And if you're looking to start playing Pathfinder, or you already are playing Pathfinder on Roll20, all the stuff that they've made for Pathfinder 2nd Edition on Roll20 is now on sale for 40% off. Moving on to charities. Itch.io has got a huge mega bundle for LGBTQ rights. Except for all the funds will be go to LPT and trans rights groups in Florida. As you know, the LGBT crowd are suffering under a huge threat from the Florida government. So if that's something you want to support, you could buy this bundle. It's got about 500 more various bizarre titles that are stuff like that. If you're familiar with the itch.io bundles, it's usually one or two games you actually want, and then 499 games you will never play. So this is one of those times when I would say, you know what, just if that's a charity you want to support and that's a cause you want to support, just give the money directly to LGBTQ rights charities that are fighting for the rights of the LGBT individuals who live in Florida, because we don't like itch.io. Over at Bundle of Holding, Owen Steffens has put together a bundle to help pay for his medical bills. He's got a whole bunch of Pathfinder 2nd Edition adventures, including an entire AP called the Scaldwood Blight Adventure Path. $10 will, and it all go, all is for the bundle. Yeah, coffee time. $10 is the price for the bundle, and it will be 100% go to the medical bills of Owen Steffens. Pinnacle has a memorial fund being set up for the Jonathan Thompson, who, as we know, passed away earlier this month. The bundle has over 150 products from 100 different publishers, many titles for Savage World and source books and stuff like that. All the funds will go to the family of Mr. Thompson to support them in their time of grief and to help them with any, you know, medical bills or funeral bills or whatever. $25 gets the bundle. And it goes to support the family of Jonathan Thompson, who passed away. We've got another one from itch.io. This is the still running their solo but not alone bundle. This will be the 8th, 10th week in a row this bundle has been running. 150 single-player tabletop role-playing game titles. $10 gets you the entire bundle. It all goes to support Jasper's Game Day. 10 weeks in a row, itch.io, and you're still pushing it, which means to me it's not really selling. So I don't know. Maybe there's just no market for single player tabletop role playing games. Yeah, whatever. Over bundle of holding, we have a GURPS bundle. The first bundle is all the GURPS combat books. So like GURPS Martial Arts, which I worked on. GURPS Gun Fu, GURPS Tactical Shooting, all the high-tech books like GURPS Transhuman Space, GURPS Science Fiction, all that other stuff. $18 gets you the entire collection. It's direct relief, which means 10% of all the sales will go directly to Steve Jackson. The rest goes someplace else. Then we have a GURPS Supers bundles. Hey, you know, GURPS Supers, always a place in my heart, considering I helped write it, even though they don't give me credit for it anymore. So this is everything that has been made for GURPS Super up to now. It's $10 for the entire collection, and it goes to direct relief. There is a Warhammer 40K Dark Heresy Black Crusade and Only War bundle. It's got 46 titles, all set in the Warhammer 40K RPG universe. I don't know why they had to make the title like that, but it's the Warhammer 40K Dark Heresy Black Crusade Only War bundle. Does that mean something to anybody who plays Warhammer 40K? So is like the campaign named Dark Heresy, is the adventure called the Black Crusade, and then the supplement called Only War? Or is it just one name? Is that the name of the entire thing? I don't know. Commas are your friends. $25, and this goes to help children hospitals. There is a huge bundle of RPG mapping software available on Humble Bumble. It's got Modern Mapper, Age of Exploration, Campaign Cartographer, a classic, Cosmo Cartographer for making space maps, a whole bunch of mapping and terrain and drawing type things. So if you can't draw like me and you want to computer program that does all that work for you, this bundle is available. $30 gets you at least 10 campaign cartographer map making type programs. That's huge, considering one of these usually runs anywhere from 50 or up. This goes to support charities that deal with the pollution of the ocean, including one called Carbon Funding Organization and Oceana. But remember, these are actual programs, so if you are going to spend the $30 to download the entire bundle, check each and every one for malware and viruses. Now remember, I mentioned that there was a huge Shadowrun bundle. Catalyst Games is running a huge Shadowrun mega bundle featuring everything you need for the 5th edition of Shadowrun. $18 gets you everything that has been made so far for the 5th edition of Shadowrun. And this goes to support food banks. As somebody who had to live off of food banks for a long time, yes, support food banks. They are a necessary charity. Or you could just give the money directly to your local food bank or give them, you know, canned food or whatever. And then we have the Trollords Castles and Crusades bundle, which for $18 pretty much gets you 35 Castles and Crusades rule books and source books. This goes to support veteran charities and veteran relief. And as you know, I'm a huge fan of Castles and Crusades. It is the game that many consider to be Gary Gygax's legacy. Castles and Crusades is the game that Wizards of the Coast stole the mechanics from to create 5e. And it's one of the few game companies that are like, hey, screw you, Wizards of the Coast. We're still going to do what we're going to do because your OGL nonsense doesn't affect us. So if you want to pick up pretty much everything that's been made for Castles and Crusades, you can do this now for $18, and it goes to support veteran relief charities, which are a good charity. The ElfQuest bundle is still available. It features pretty much 13 volumes of the top-tier 45-year-long run of ElfQuest. $18 gets you the entire run. It's a huge comic book thing that was unbelievably big in the 80s, at least where I was in the late 80s, early 90s. Like, everybody and their dog was ElfQuest, 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 ElfQuest. I mean, every conversation that I was in, at, you know, for like the first 2 years of college that didn't revolve around actual college stuff was ElfQuest. So, yeah. And then we have a video editing software bundle. This features a whole bunch of video editing programs, including Pro 18, Audio Studio, Music Maker, samples, and other stuff. So if you're thinking of getting into the world of video editing and you want to have a good collection starter bundle of the various softwares available to you, this one is available for $25. It goes to support a charity called the Malala Fund. I don't know what that is. But yeah, that's a good bundle considering that most of these on their own cost anywhere from $30 to $100. These are actual programs. So again, if you're going to download them, check them for viruses and malware. So that's this week's bundles. And obviously the ones that stand out to me are the Trollord Games Castles and Crusades bundle, link down below. The Shadowrun 5e bundle, link down below. And the Gurps Supers bundle, because I helped write Gurps Supers, so link down below. But as always with these bundles, if you download any of these PDFs, please check them for viruses. Or you could just ignore everything I just said over the past 10 minutes. Head on over to Big Geek Emporium. Take that money that you would have spent on these bundles and instead buy my merch! Because I've got eight amazing collections of brand new system neutral monsters available for you at a price of only $2 each on Big Geek Emporium. Why support somebody you've never known or never heard of or a charity you don't know anything about when you could just support me? Because I'm awesome. I'm the OGGM. Please like, please share. Please subscribe. Please stay safe because it's still raining, but it's the first day of spring, so happy spring. And if any of these bundles sound like something that you're excited about, let me know if you picked it up and what you thought of it. Till next time, see ya.